One ever shall be.
Already mired in a maelstrom of controversy, the Catholic Church could be dealing with more legal woes regarding sex abuse, putting Pope Benedict in the spotlight. He and the Vatican are facing a federal lawsuit filed in the United States. For the first time, a U.S. court will decide whether the Pope can be held liable for a nationwide priest abuse scandal.
It is an attempt to embarrass the papacy and the Catholic Church.
Victims who have alleged sexual abuse by the hands of priests say the problem needs to be exposed and dealt with, even if it includes the Pope's negligence.
We want to keep pushing for what we've been pushing for, and that's a certain amount of transparency on the bishop's part to show the records, show what they're doing, showing how they're handling it, show us the records how they handled it in the past.
Attorneys dispatched by the Vatican are trying to get the case dismissed. They say the Pope shouldn't be held liable because he's a head of state, and American bishops involved in the case are not direct employees of the Vatican. They say the case is without merit. Experts say it'll be a tough argument for plaintiffs' attorneys.
As a secular state, we really don't have the means to judge these. Ultimately, the Church is accountable to its own doctrine and teachings, and to God.
One of the biggest outcomes in cases like this happened in 2003. That one involved 200 claims of sexual abuse and was settled for $25 million. But because of the ongoing scandal surrounding the church, this one is not just grabbing attention.
What's driving it is the publicity and the shame that the church experiences to see the way in which power and authority has been abused in some cases.
The judge hearing the case will have to listen to both sides, involving arguments and motions. But for now, there's no deadline on when the judge will make a final decision regarding the case. Colin Campbell, Washington.